بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم النفس تبكي على الدنيا وقد علمت إن السلامة فيها ترك ما فيها لا دار للمرء بعد الموت يسكنها إلا التي كان قبل الموت بانيها فإن بناها بخير طاب مسكنها وإن بناها بشر خاب بانيها. السلام عليكم my dear brothers and sisters. Another beautiful poem for you today from Ali radiallahu anhu, the cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the son-in-law of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the fourth Khalifa of Islam, one of the lions of the mu'mineen and the muslimin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Ali radiallahu anhu with many things. One of them was marriage to Fatima, the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and another was that he had powerful intellect. He was also very eloquent and he used to quote and say poetry. And this is a poem which has been compiled or attributed to him. A beautiful poem to show just how he was thinking and just how he was feeling and the advice that he'd be giving to the people. So he said, "An-nafsu tabki 'ala ad-dunya wa qad 'alimat inna as-salamata fiha tarku ma fiha." What a paradox this is. He says that the soul cries over dunya whilst knowing that peace and happiness is only obtained from the dunya by leaving the dunya. So the soul knows this. And if you want peace in the dunya, you will only obtain this by leaving the dunya, not chasing after materialistic things. How interesting that is. Then he says, لَا دَارَ لِلْمَرْءِ بَعْدَ الْمَوْتِ يَسْكُنُهَا إِلَّا الَّتِي قَانَ قَبْلَ الْمَوْتِ بَانِيهَا. He goes, there is no house, there is no home for a person after he dies except for the house which he has built for himself before he dies. Interesting. So people spend hundreds and thousands of millions building for them their nice detached house in this world, with the nice area in the good location, with the amenities nearby, with the schools nearby, with the swimming pools and the colleges and everything you need nearby. And here he's saying, this house isn't going to go with you after you die. The only house which is going to be with you after you die is what you have put forward, i.e. from your good deeds. From your good deeds and your good actions, that is the house that you build for yourself after you die. That is where you will live. But what kind of house are we going to live in after we die? Well, there are two houses. It can be a very nice one which we're satisfied with, or it can be perhaps an ugly one where we are not satisfied, or we are not content, or we are perhaps upset with ourselves that we could have done more. He says, فَإِن بَنَاهَا بِخَيْرٍ قَابَ مَسْكَنُهَا وَإِن بَنَاهَا بِشَرٍ خَابَ بَانِيهَا. And if the house is built upon good, then your dwelling will please you. But if the house is built upon bad, then this dwelling where you put yourself, it will not be pleasing to you. It will be a disappointment to you. So my dear brothers and sisters, do what you have to live in this world. There's no doubt about that. But just remember, whatever house that you live in, whatever area that you reside in, you are not going to take it with you. Except the only thing that you will take with you is that which you put forward with your own two hands. So Jazakallah khairan, my dear brothers and sisters, something to think about whilst we go to work and come back and earn our daily bread. I'm your brother Akhlaaq. Look forward to seeing you soon. Take care. Assalamu alaikum.